In this video, let's look at a split washer and a roll pin, sometimes called a spring pin. Both of these parts have a slot cut in them. Because we are using the split washer in an assembly, I will only model it in the flat state. The roll pin positions the drill press headstock on the end of the column. We can model the basic shape of the washer the same as in the last video. We can extrude the region between two circles as before. We can model the roll pin just like modeling a tube. We sketch just the outer diameter and extrude using a two-sided offset option. The offset is 0 to the outside and negative the wall thickness to the inside. A simple way to create the slot in the roll pin is to sketch a single line. Notice that I am sketching on the coordinate system instead of the end face, which is a better practice. I extrude with a symmetric offset. This is half the slot width to each side. I extrude through all using the Boolean subtract option. The symmetric offset basically gives the line thickness. To create the slot on the split washer, we can do the same thing, but sketch a line at an angle, then drag it by the center point to constrain it to the origin. By the way, dragging to constrain the center point is an NX 11 enhancement. If you have an older version, create a midpoint constraint between the line and the origin, and then create a point on curve constraint. The last step is to add the final chamfers on the ends of the roll pin, which makes it easier to assemble. Again, let's combine the two chamfers into one feature by selecting both edges in the same feature. Following the same outline used in the last videos, we have tried to find simple ways to model these parts. The easy way to create the detailed slot features on both of these parts was to use the offset option on the extrude command.